The future is here. SpaceX launches space factories. SpaceX is aiming for the ultimate mission. It appears that SpaceX will remain at the top for a long time. Elon Musk is already working on his next mission, which will alter the manufacturing industry. He intends to construct factories in space. Is it possible to have a manufacturing industry in space? This idea may appear far-fetched, and besides, there is enough space on Earth to build a factory. Nonetheless, the concept could be helpful for industries on the ground. How? Well, that's what we'll discuss today. So, let's get started. Varda Space Industries is a company that seeks to develop manufacturing facilities in space. The company plans to collaborate with SpaceX to tackle this seemingly impossible task to create materials in zero gravity. In 2023, it will launch its first spacecraft into orbit on a SpaceX Falcon 9 rocket. The spaceship is expected to spend 3 months testing space manufacturing technology, according to reports. The spacecraft will be Varda's first spacecraft to reach orbit. Rocket Lab, a competitor to SpaceX, will build the spaceship. Varda will get 2 more spacecraft from it. Varda's modules will have these 3 vehicles attached to them. One is a re-entry capsule, while the other is a manufacturing module for microgravity. This spacecraft's mission is to stay in orbit for 3 months. It's also hoped that the re-entry module will return with 40 to 60 kilograms of produced goods. Varda's mission is to discover the advantages of microgravity. The benefits of microgravity can only be found over extended periods in space. Varda is interested in seeing how it may make unique materials such as specialized semiconductors or bioprinted organs. This company believes that there's a massive market for such materials. They need to put more effort in exploring this. A new and lucrative program called Falcon 9 ride-sharing lowers the cost of traveling to space. So you've heard of carpooling, right? To save money and gas, we usually carpool. Elon Musk is attempting something similar to orbit. Customers can join a spaceship pool to save money on space travel. This man, on the other hand, is a genius. For an individual customer wishing to deliver up to 200 kilograms of cargo to Sun synchronous orbit, SpaceX claims to reduce the launch cost to as little as $1 million. Essentially, after the companies that travel to space together arrive at their destination, they're free to go their own ways. Same as we go our own ways here on Earth. Varda executives say that they chose SpaceX because it's the most reliable and cost-effective route to access space. Varda is a new firm and they can't afford the high cost of space launches on its own, so it partnered with SpaceX. We all know that SpaceX has prioritized taking people to space, followed by Mars and the Moon. However, it has shown that it's not lagging behind when it comes to hardware launches. SpaceX is now providing launch services, and it will launch small satellites and call this project the Transporter Missions. SpaceX's numerous launches of Starlink satellites are not the same as the Transporter Missions. This transport mission aims to reduce the time it takes for a small satellites built by various organizations and enterprises to launch. However, all great missions meet difficulties. Varda faces specific problems as well. Setting up a manufacturing facility in space sounds fantastic, but gravity is a problem. Because there's no gravity up there, it will result in buoyancy. It will make forming metals and alloys extremely difficult. High quantities of radiation, harsh temperatures, and other factors will be present. However, it comes with several benefits, so it's all worthwhile. You might be astonished to learn that the vacuum and microgravity of space enables the research and creation of things that would otherwise be impossible to produce here on Earth. Imagine how many doors it could open to fresh discoveries that we haven't even considered. Raw materials might be transferred to low Earth orbit and converted into commodities before being delivered back to Earth. This campaign aims to protect the environment. Fine technical products like computer chips could be made with greater accuracy because of the low gravity and lack of dust particles. Gold, platinum, and silver can also be carried to Earth's lower orbit for processing, which has the potential to become economically feasible. The International Space Station is always on the move. It regularly conducts advanced materials investigations and contributes to the creation of new production techniques. Some of these strategies may be useful to manufacturing in outer space. Also, you'll be happy to know that Varda has also raised almost $50 million for its first mission. Will Bruy, Delian Asparuhov, and Daniel Marshall were the founders of Varda. Its headquarters are in the state of California. So far, they put together a team of 16 people from all around the aerospace industry, with plans to expand Varda to more than 40 people by the time it launches. But the question now is whether this will lead to large-scale production on the planet. Many companies are still working on it to make it a reality. Few firms, such as Moon Express, have looked at the idea of mining raw resources of the planet. We can speculate that corporations like Varda Space may have several factories in space or Earth orbit, or elsewhere in the solar system in the future.